To all of you. As you all know, every week we learn something new and then in the next class we revise what we have learned. So in today's class, all of you will revise what you have learned in the previous class. And if we have time, we will also learn the rest of the options of the paragraph. Can you tell what happens with default formatting? Default formatting is an option which helps you to remove any formatting done on your line or paragraph and bring it back to its original form. Can you say why we use character submenu? Using character submenu, you can do many types of formatting on your text or paragraph, like changing the writing style of the writing, changing the size of the text, making the entire text capital or small, making the text blink, hiding the text or paragraph, overlining, underlining, or striking through on the text, etc. Now, all of you switch on your computer and open your writer file. Let us now begin today's class. In this class, you will revise what we learned in the previous class and later learn about the submenus of the paragraph. Now, all of you type the paragraph being shown to you. Have you all typed the paragraph? Select the entire paragraph and change its writing style. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn. Let us watch this video and practice how we can change the style of our writing or the font type. So to change the font type, we need to first select our paragraph. So go ahead and select the paragraph by any of the methods that you have learned. Once you have selected it, take the pointer to the format option of the menu bar and left click with your mouse or touchpad. And from the options that open, click on the character option. This is also being shown to you in the video. Once you click here, a box opens. Click on the font option in this box on the top as is shown in the video. Just below this you will see font is written and there are many types of fonts or writing styles shown. You can keep your pointer on the scroll button and keep the left button pressed and then you can scroll up or down to see the different styles of writing available. Go ahead and select one of the styles which you like and then click on that option. Later go and click on OK and you will see that the style of your writing on the selected paragraph on the writer page changes. So this is how you can change the font style. Next, select the first line and show how you can change the size of the writing and make it bigger. If you face a problem, learn by watching the video. Let us now practice changing the font size of the selected text. So to change the font size, we need to first select the line, text or paragraph that we want to change the font size of. So as shown in the video, we have selected a line. Now take your pointer to the format option of the menu bar and left click with the mouse or the touchpad and then click on the character option. In the box that opens, click on the font option and Within this, look for the size option. Take your pointer there and hold the left button of the mouse or the touchpad down so that you can scroll up or down for the writing size. Once you select the writing size, you can click on OK and you will see that your font size of the selected text has been changed. Next, select the second line and change the color of the text. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn from it. We will now practice changing the font color. So to do that, let us select the next line of our paragraph. As is being shown in the video, we select the second line and then take our pointer to the format option of the menu bar and select that by left clicking on the mouse or the touchpad. Click on the character option and from the box that opens, click on the font effects option. Once you click there, look for font color and then bring your pointer to the down arrow and click on it. You can click on the scroll button, keep the mouse left button pressed and scroll up or down and select the color of your choice. Then press OK on the OK option and you will see that the font color of the selected line gets changed to the color that you had selected. Move ahead and select the third line and make it blink. Again, if you have any doubts about how to do this, watch the video and learn from the same. With the help of this video, we will learn how we can make on our writer page blink. So to blink the text, first select the line that you want to blink. As is being shown in the video, after you have selected the line, take the pointer to the format option of the menu bar and select the same. Then from the options, select the character option. And in the box, you can see the blinking option in the font effects area or option. Click on that so that you get a tick mark and then click on OK. You will see that your line that you had selected starts getting blinked or it starts blinking. So this way you can make the selected text on your writer page blink. Next, change all the remaining lines to small letters and then change it back to capital letters. Again, if in doubt, watch the video. With the help of this video, we will learn how to make our selected lines in small capital. So for this, first select the remaining lines of the paragraph as is being shown in the video and then take your pointer to the format option of the menu bar, click on character option and within the font effects look for the effects option. When you click on the down arrow, you can see different options here. Since you have to make small capitals, choose small capitals and click on it and then click on OK. And you will see that the text line or paragraph that you had selected changes into small capitals. Let us now learn more about the other options of the paragraph. Can you say why we use the paragraph submenu? The paragraph submenu helps you decide how much space you want to leave before the paragraph. The paragraph submenu helps you decide how much space you want to leave before the paragraph, that is, before you start typing your text. You can also decide how much space you want to leave after typing your paragraph. There are other options also, which help you in setting the margins for the paragraph. Next, you will learn about the indent and spacing for paragraph submeno. Can you tell why we use indent and spacing? As we can make out from the names, indent and spacing help us to give spaces in our line or paragraph. Let us now learn how to use indent and spacing by watching the video. In this video, we will learn about the use of indent and spacing on our writer page. As the name implies, indent and spacing is used to provide spaces in our written text. To use this, we have to take our pointer to the format option of the menu bar, click there with the left button of the mouse or touchpad, and then click on paragraph option. In the paragraph option, click on indent and spacing. You will see three different options are there for indent, for spacing, and for line spacing. First, we will learn about the indent. Indent is shown here of two types, before text and after text. So if we use the before text option, it will create space before the text that you are typing. So if you bring your pointer or the up arrow and click on it, you will see that the paragraph lines move towards the right side and there is space before the lines. So if you now click on OK, this indent will get applied and you can see that your lines of the paragraph have moved towards the right side away from the text boundary. So this is indent before the paragraph. Now, if you want to bring it back to normal, you will take the pointer again to the format option of the menu bar, click on it, and then click on the paragraph option and bring your pointer here to the before text indent area and then click on the down arrow to bring it back to zero so that the indent gets removed and your text returns to normal. You click on OK and you can see that the text begins from the text boundary and there is no indent, no spacing before the paragraph. Let's look at the other option. Click on format, click on paragraph, and then take your pointer to the after text, the up arrow here, and click on it. And what happens now is that there is space between the boundary text on the right side and the text lines. So once you click OK, you can see as is being shown in the video. To bring it back to normal, again take the pointer to the format option, click there, click on paragraph, and then in the indent and spacing after text, click on the down arrow and bring it to zero, click on OK, and you will see that your text has returned to normal. Now let us see the next option. To do that, again bring your pointer to the format option of the menu bar, go to paragraph, and then we are going to look at spacing. Spacing can be above the paragraph, you can leave some space before your paragraph begins, or below the paragraph, as you can see in the options shown in spacing. So to change the spacing above the paragraph, you will take your pointer to the up arrow in the above paragraph option and then click on that to increase the space above the paragraph. If you click on the down arrow and bring it back to zero, there will be no space above the paragraph as it was originally. Similarly, to use below the paragraph, there will be space left below the paragraph. So, if we bring a pointer to the up arrow and increase it, the space below the paragraph increases. And if we click on the down arrow and bring it back to zero, the space below the paragraph decreases. And if you press OK, it gets applied on our paragraph. Now, we will also learn about the third option, which is line spacing. If you bring your pointer to this down arrow and click on it, you will see that there are various options for line spacing. In the normal line spacing, it is single spaced, but you can do 1.5 times. If you click there, you can see the effect here. 1.5 times space is left between the lines. Then if you click on double space is left. And if you click on OK, you can see that in your written text on the paragraph, double lines are left. To bring it back to normal, go to Format, go to the Paragraph option, and from the line spacing, select Single and press on OK. So this is how you use indent and spacing on your written text on the writer page. Now, you will learn about the alignment option of the paragraph submenu. Can you say why we use the alignment option? We use the alignment option to center our text or to left or right justify it. Let us watch the video and learn how to use the alignment option. With the help of this video, we are going to learn to use the alignment option on our text on the writer page. Alignment can be of four types: left align, right align, center align, and justify align. To use this, bring your pointer to the format option of the menu bar, click on it, and then click on the paragraph option. Now, look for the tab saying alignment or the option saying alignment and click on that. You can see there are four types of alignment: left, right, center, and justified. The left alignment is by default set on the writer page. So when you type, your text starts from the left margin. If you want to change this, click on right, and you can see here that the paragraph gets aligned to the right margin. If you click on center, you will notice that your paragraph lines get aligned to the center or come in the center. If you click on justified alignment, all the lines become equal. So if you want to select, let's say, the center alignment, you click on center and then click on OK. And when you look at the text on your paragraph, you will see that the paragraph has got center aligned. If you want to bring it back to normal, click on Format, click on Paragraph, and then click on the left alignment and click OK. And it comes back to normal. So this is how you use alignment option. Now, you will learn about the drop caps in the paragraph submenu. Can you say what drop caps are used for? Drop caps is a type of font style using which you can make the first letter or the first word of your paragraph bold and in capitals. For example, you would have seen that in English newspapers, the first letter or the first word is darker than the rest of the text and is in capital letters. To do this in your text, you can use drop caps. Let us watch the video and learn how drop caps is to be used. In this video, we will learn how to use the drop caps option to make the first letter or the first word as we choose in dark and capital. To do this, bring your pointer to the Format option and then click on Paragraph and within the box that opens, click on the tab for drop caps. Now you see there are options shown here, but they are not highlighted. Whole word, number of characters, lines or space to text is not highlighted. When we click on the display drop caps, then all these options get highlighted. Now number of characters is the number of alphabets or the characters that you want to get affected by drop caps. You can bring your pointer to this option and click on this option here, and you can use the number keys on your keyboard to increase or decrease, or you can use the scroll up arrow, the drop up arrow and the scroll down arrow to increase the number of characters. This is to make a change in the number of characters that you want to apply the drop caps to. The next option is the lines. The number of lines that this drop cap option will cover. So beyond the drop caps option where you apply on the character, the number of lines that you want to cover, like in this case we have shown 6, and the space to text is the space between the drop caps character and the next lines. So between the spacing, you can either increase it by the up arrow or decrease it by the down arrow. The text option shows you the text that you are applying drop caps to. And the character style, if you click on the drop down arrow, you can see many styles of character, and you can choose by scrolling up or down the character that you like, the character style, and then click on OK. So you see here that in our case we had applied the character for to be on drop caps in front of 6 lines. So that is shown here. If you want to change it, go back to format, click on paragraph. You can decrease the number of lines by clicking here on the down arrow. Make it 3 or 2 as you like. We make it 3. Then between the space of the drop cap and the other lines, we are making the line the space 0. And from the character style, we apply OK. And you see that the drop cap comes in front of 3 lines of our paragraph, and there is no spacing between the drop cap character and the lines. Again, if you want to make a change, click on format, click on paragraph, and then you can decrease the number of lines. You can click on this portion and use the number keys also, and then click on OK. So you will see that the drop caps is applied to 2 lines. If you want to remove this, just go to the paragraph option again, click on the display drop characters and click on OK. So your paragraph will become as it was originally. Now you will learn about the border option of the paragraph submenu. Can you say why we use the border option? The border option helps you to get a border or a line on all 4 sides of your paragraph or text. By using this option, your text or paragraph will appear within the border, and then you will not be able to type outside the border. If you like, you can change the size or color of the border line. Let us watch the video and learn about using the border. By watching this video, we are going to learn how we can apply borders on our text paragraph. So to do that, we first need to bring our pointer to the format option of the menu bar. Click on that and then click on the paragraph option. Now from the box that opens, look for the borders tab or the borders option and click on that. So you will see a number of options being displayed for borders. The first one is the line arrangement and then the line style. So if you look at the line arrangement, there are four options shown here. Like it is being shown in the video. If you click on the first, it will have no borders around the paragraph. In the second, it sets borders on all four sides as is being shown in the video to you. If you select the third one, it sets borders on the left and the right side of the paragraph. And the fourth option is to set the borders on the top and the bottom of the paragraph. Like this, as is being shown in the video. And the last option is to set a border on the left side of the paragraph. So if we choose set all sides of a border, we can click on this option. And now let's see what else we can do. We can change the style of the line that we want to set the border with. So the line of the border will change according to the style. So you can drag on the scroll button up and down and you see different types of lines, thin lines, double lines, bold lines, thick lines. So you click on the one which you like and that will get applied to your paragraph border. You can also change the color of the border line. You can see that there is a color option below here as is being shown in the video. Click on the down arrow and you see many options, many colors appearing. You can scroll up and down by clicking on the mouse or the touchpad and then scrolling up and down and select the color that you like. For instance, here the red color has been selected. And you can see it will get applied once you do OK. So this is how you can get a border on your paragraph on all four sides. In this video, we will learn how we can provide spacing to the contents from the border within a paragraph on the writer page. So to do this, bring your cursor to the format option and click on paragraph. And in the borders tab or borders option, you see spacing to contents option is there. This is for left, right, top and bottom. So if you click on the up arrow and increase the distance from the border to 0.18 centimeter and click OK. So you see in the paragraph, the text appears at 0.18 centimeters away from the border, from the left border. Let's try and change the other options. Go back to format, click on paragraph option, and you can do the same with the spacing to content for the right border, 0.18 centimeters from the right border. Similarly for the top and the bottom, you can make the change or increase the space from the borders. Now you see another option here which says synchronize. If you click on the synchronize option and when you see the tick mark, what it means is that if you make any change to the left, right, top or bottom, that change will apply to all of these options, the left, right, top and bottom, all will change. From the left border, all of them have changed to 0.08. And if we click on OK, we see that our text is 0.08 centimeters from all the borders. So this is how you use spacing from the border. This video teaches us how we can apply a shadow on our borders. To do this, bring your pointer to the format option in the menu bar, click on it, and then from the options shown, click on the paragraph option. The box opens, and in the borders tab or in the borders option, down below you see shadow style. Right now no option has been selected. Once you select any of these positions, all the options get selected. So the first position is for no shadow, or we are choosing that no shadow should be applied to the borders. So let us see one by one what are the other options. The next option is cast the shadow to the bottom right side of the border. The next option, the difference from the first one, this one is to cast shadow to the top right side of the border. The next one is cast a shadow to the bottom left side. So now you select one of these and then come to distance. This is the distance from the border that the shadow gets applied. So you can increase or decrease the distance of the shadow from the border. By clicking on the up arrow, it increases. By clicking on the down arrow, it decreases. Then there is a color option. Click on this drop down arrow and then scroll up or down to see the various colors. And you can choose whichever you like, and then you click on OK and you will see that the shadow has got applied to the border. We will be ending this class here. All of you, close your writer file and properly shut down the system. In today's class, you have learned about some of the options of the format menu, like what is default formatting, what are characters, what are the indent and spacing options of the paragraph, what is alignment, what are drop caps, and how do we use the border option. Thank you.